What are you staring at? You ain't my mommy. How about this outfit? I thought they wanted me to play a baby grand, not a grand baby. I don't mean to seem irritable, but I'm cutting a toot. And if anyone tries to chuck me under the chin, I'll bite their hand off. When they told me they were gonna change the formula on the show, I didn't know they meant this. Anyway, folks, we're bringing a great show to your doorsteps tonight. So don't abandon us. We got Jimmy Rogers. You can bet your booties he'll entertain you. Every time he sings, he's got him standing in the incubators. Another kid joining us tonight is that likable, lovable, Lebanese, Danny Thomas. Hold it down, folks. Hold it down. I think he's cute, too. But we don't have to spoil him. You know, being a baby is awful. Everybody comes up, and every time anybody comes by, they pick me up, hug and kiss me, hug and kiss me, hug and kiss me, hug and kiss me. By the time I'm 7 years old, the thrill will be gone. And right now, to put the whipped cream on the pablum, we got four girls who should be related because they all have the same last name. Nanny, take me to the Leonard
sisters. Like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel. Never ending or beginning on an ever spinning reel. Like a snowball down a mountain or a carnival balloon. Like a carousel that's turning, running rings around the moon. Like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face. And the world is like an apple whirling silently in space. Like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind. Going out of my head over you, out of my head over you, out of my head day and night, night and day and night, wrong or right. I must think of a way into your heart. There's no reason why my being shy should keep us apart. A tunnel that you follow to a tunnel of its own. Down a hollow to a cavern where the sun is never shown.
Like a door that keeps revolving in a half-forgotten dream.
Or the ripples from a pebble someone tosses in a stream. Like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its day. And the world is like an apple whirling silently in space.
And I think I'm going out of my head.
Like yes, I think I'm going out of my head. In the windmills
oh,
of
I
your
think
mind.
I'm going out of my head.
Like
yes,
I think I'm going out of my head. In the windmills
oh,
of
I
your mind.
Oh, I think I'm going out of my head.
Like yes, I think I'm
ladies and gentlemen, Here he is, that handsome Italian singer, Jimmy Durante.
Everybody loves somebody sometimes. Oh, the heck.
Impression of Dean Martin.
Dean Martin? I thought I was doing Engelbert Humperdinck. If I was doing Dean Martin, I would have slid down a fire pole.
Wouldn't that be difficult? I mean, sliding down a pole?
No, sliding down is nothing. Sliding up is the tough part.
Well, you look like you're ready for another great evening.
I sure am. I hope the world is too.
I'm sure it is, Jimmy.
I hope so, because if it ain't, I'd hate to go without it.
Have you got a number prepared for us today?
Prepared? Are you kidding? I took it out of the freezer, removed it from the furl, thawed it out, put it on the barbecue, and I'm going to render it for you right now. As I approach the prime of my life, I find I have the time of my life. Learning to enjoy at my leisure all the simple pleasures, and so I happily conceive. This is all I ask. This is all I need. Beautiful girl, walk a little slower when you walk by me. Lingering sunsets, stay a little longer with the lonely sea. Children everywhere, when you shouted bad men shoot at me, take me to that strange enchanted land. Grown-ups seldom understand wandering rainbows leave a bit of color for my heart to own. Stars in the sky make my wish come true before the night has flown, and let the music play as long as there's a song to sing. And I will stay younger than spring.
Wandering rainbows leave a bit of color for my heart to own. Stars in the sky make my wish come true before the night has flown.
Let the music play.
Let it play
as long as there's a song to sing. And I will stay younger than spring.
I will stay younger than spring.
You are watching Jimmy Durante Presents the Lennon Sisters Hour with tonight's guests, Jimmy Rogers, and special guest star, Danny Thomas.
I'm honored to speak on behalf of the United Way.
The United Way gives us the opportunity to help in a very personal way.
The United Way has flourished all these years because it drew upon the American habit of neighbor helping neighbor.
The extraordinary generosity of your past contributions is a clear tribute to the enduring power of American community spirit.
No value is more deeply ingrained in our national life than that of community responsibility.
And that's what United Way is all about.
They provide us with a splendid opportunity
to help shape a better America.
And one of our most valuable resources is our spirit of volunteerism.
We want to keep alive that great tradition, that great spirit in America.
I encourage all Americans to support their local United Way to help build and rebuild communities we can be proud of.
We practically grew up in television with our next guest, and the best way to introduce him is, ladies and gentlemen, let's make room for Granddaddy,
Danny Thomas.
Thank you very much, young ladies. You're right, I did help raise you through television, that's true. And how about those girls? Aren't they doing a magnificent job in television this year? I think they're just fine. And you can call me Granddaddy all you want. I'm very proud of it. How about that? Me, a grandfather. I'll tell you, it's a wonderful feeling. Just happened, you know, last month. The only thing I don't like about it is from now on, I'll be sleeping with a grandmother. Not so long ago, we had a one-hour version of our Make Room for Daddy series, you know, where Rusty's wife has a baby. Well, you know, in the play, I acted real nervous and got everything all fouled up. As a matter of fact, everybody in the house was fouled up. There was absolute bedlam in our home. When I saw it on TV, I thought we were overdoing it. You want to know something? It was twice as nutty in real life. I mean it. Nobody believed what we did. Our daughter, Terry, came into our bedroom, and she very calmly said, Mother, Dad, I think it's time. I jumped out of bed. I got into my pants, backwards, of course. And we rushed into the car. I stepped in the gas. We raced to the hospital. And when we got there, it hit me. We forgot Terry. And my wife said, What are we going to do? What are we going to do? I screamed, You have the baby. Terry's only a kid, after all. Now, if we had done that on TV, nobody would have believed it. But anyway, thank the good Lord, Terry gave birth to a beautiful little girl. Her name is Dionne Teresa. She weighs 6 pounds, 8 ounces, and 19 inches long. Notice how I remembered all the vital statistics? I'll tell you, she's some kind of kid. But I'm not going to spoil her like other grandfathers do. No, sir, I'm not going to spoil little Dionne. She's not getting a car from me until she's finished with her skates. And her tricycle, and her bicycle, and her surfboard. What are you gonna do? You gotta spoil them, I guess. And the fight's already started. And it's not me, I guarantee it isn't. You know, the way they take care of babies today is different than in the old days. As a matter of fact, I used to fight with my wife when our son Tony was just a little guy. Now, she used to give him a bath every day. And that used to burn me up. I mean, giving a kid a bath every day, I couldn't understand it. I mean, where'd he get a chance to get dirty? He never left his crib. It's silly. We used to get a bath once a week when I was a kid. Every day she gave that kid a bath. I swore by the time he was 15 years old, he was going to have soggy bones. Bath every day. We were 10 children in our family. Mother and father, 12 human beings. We had one bathroom. We got a bath once a week. In my house, they take a bath every day. We got 12 bathrooms. They're plunging all the time. Every day they take a bath. Not me. I'm sticking with tradition. I ain't losing my natural oils for anybody. A bath every day is the most ridiculous thing I ever heard of. We got a bath once a week. My mother threw us in a tub 4 at a time to soak like laundry. We had no stopper. Us kids took turns sitting on a drain. You're laughing. I had the most beautiful set of rings you ever saw in your whole life. Nothing to be ashamed of. No, I mean, they pamper kids today. We never got pampered. Would you believe it? My wife is now using a thermometer to test the bathwater for her grandchild. I mean, whatever happened to the old elbow test? You know, my mother never even used her elbow. She used me for a thermometer. I swear, it's true. She used to throw me in a tub if I came out red, it was too hot. Came out blue, it was too cold. Once I came out white, my aunt was in the tub. I was only 18 at the time. Well, anyway, times have changed. They're taking care of babies a lot better nowadays, and for the better, too. After all, that's progress. And speaking of progress, let's progress with this show, shall we? I'm going to sing a song for you, a song that I wrote for my granddaughter, Dion. But first, I want to show you a picture of her that I brought with me. Oh, it's in the back here. It's just a little snapshot. I was telling her one of my jokes at the time. You notice how interested she was? Yeah, I'm a proud old grandpappy, but I guess all grandpappies have a right to be proud. You know, years ago, on the cover of Collier's magazine on Father's Day, there was this inscription. I'll never forget it. It read, "What is a father? A father is a man who gives his daughter to another man who isn't half good enough, so they can give him grandchildren who are twice as good as anybody's." So true. Dion. 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 Part moonlight, part starlight, part dawn. Dion, Dion, you smile and my troubles are gone. Dion, my Dion, God bless the day you were born. You must have been sent from heaven above for me to care for and cherish and love. Dear darling Dion, Dion, my Dion, God bless the day you were born. Now, Grandma and I never will die. We shall live on and on and on through you, dear darling.
Last summer, television was made a lot nicer because our next guest was on every Monday night. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Jimmy Rogers.
Years ago, whenever a man was put in prison for committing some kind of a crime, he would sometimes be taken out of the jail cell during the day along with the other prisoners to work on the road gangs, building roads for the state. Now, in the summertime, the prison officials would hire young kids from the surrounding cities to carry bags of water for the prisoners. And up and down the line, you could hear the prisoners calling to the water boys to bring them water. This song is called Water Boy, and it's a story of one man who was caught cheating, playing cards, and he was put in jail. He was a man of tremendous physical strength, and he was proud of the fact that he could work harder and faster than anybody else. And so, this story. His cries for the water boy were perhaps the most dramatic of all. Water boy, water boy, hey, water boy. Well, there ain't no hammer up on the mountain that can ring like mine, ring like mine. No, there ain't no hammer up on the mountain that can ring like mine. No, 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 ring like mine. Water boy,
diamonds up my sleeve. Now I'm working on a mountain, and I'm working with a hammer, and you can hear me every morning, hear me when I'm crying, crying water boy, hey. Well, there ain't gonna be no hammer here, hammer up on the mountain that can ring like mine, like mine, ring like mine.
Thank you, honey. Thank you very much.
I could listen to you sing for hours. Would you sing something else for me?
Will I sing something else for you?
Yeah.
Absolutely, of course. To be perfectly frank, I had to take the picks off my fingers first. To be perfectly frank with you, I'd like to sing something with you.
Well, then how about this? Let's sing a duet, and I can listen to you, and you can listen to me.
Okay, that sounds good.
Today, while the blossoms still cling to the vine, I'll taste your strawberries, I'll drink your sweet wine. A million tomorrows shall pass away, ere I forget all the joy that is mine today. I can't be contented with yesterday's glory.
I can't live on promises winter to spring.
Today is my moment, and here is my story. I'll laugh, and I'll cry, and I'll sing. Today, while the blossoms still cling to the pine, I'll taste your strawberries, I'll drink your sweet wine. A million tomorrows shall pass away, ere I forget all the joy that is mine.
Talking earlier today about all the fun we've had when we were kids, especially on holidays, and most particularly on Halloween.
Oh, that was so much fun.
We'd just spend weeks planning on what we were going to wear, and we'd go through the costume box, and it was just great. But I always wanted to be the best cowboy on the block, like Tim McCoy.
Right.
And I always wanted to be a witch, and I never was.
I know.
It seemed like we always ended up the same thing every year.
Gypsies!
I always wanted to be a princess, but Mom had lots of blouses and skirts and scarves, and so we were gypsies.
Anna would let us borrow her earrings and her bracelets and her necklaces, so every year we felt so rich like gypsies.
Do you realize when we went trick-or-treating, that was about 15 years ago?
Oh,
let's sing.
The winds may blow take with me the warmth of thee, a taste of honey, a taste much sweeter than wine. I will return, I'll return, I'll come back for the honey and you. I'll come back.
and you. He ne'er came back to his love so fair, and so she died dreaming of his kiss. His kiss was honey.
His kiss was honey.
His kiss was honey.
His kiss was honey.
A taste more bitter than wine. I will return. I'll return. I'll come back for the honey and you. I'll come back.
Before, we come from a family of 11 children, but we haven't told you each of us was born in a different month, so therefore we celebrate a different birthday just about every month.
Yep, right. And with 9 grandchildren, seems like we have parties all the time.
Even tonight we're celebrating a birthday.
That's right. My youngest son John was a year old today, so we just had his first birthday party for him.
Oh. Janet, tell him the rest.
Well, for those of you who haven't already guessed, I'm expecting our third son about the first part of January.
What a great way to start the new year.
Always change. in Seattle. And the hills, the greenest green in Seattle. Like a beautiful child growing up free and wild, full of hopes and full of fears, full of laughter, full of tears, full of dreams to last the years in Seattle.
Did you know that in Seattle, one of the landmarks is the Space Needle, and it has a restaurant on top of it?
And when you have a restaurant on top of a Space Needle, you better be careful where you sit. They're building the supersonic transport in Seattle. It's going to be the largest airplane in the world.
That's right. It'll be so big and so fast, you can get from here to New York in 2.5 hours.
Gosh.
And 3 hours if you're flying tourist.
And those two pioneers, Lewis and Clark, blazed the trail to Seattle in their search for the Northwest Passage.
Tonight we join them as they spend their last night at the last outpost of civilization. Here they are, those two intrepid explorers, Meriwether Lewis and William Clark.
Tell me, partner, did you ever have relatives pass through here?
I'm getting out of here. Things like that could give me an inferior complexion.
You can't go now. We're explorers. We're making history. We've got to cut down trees, clear the paths through the forests, and build rafts to cross the raging rivers. And we have to climb... On second thought, you're right. Let's get out of here.
No, just a minute. Hold it. Hold it. We got to get to the Northwest.
Yeah, you're right. But we better order provisions first.
I'll take care of the provisions, and while I'm at it, I'll order some food, too. Hello. Room service? Send me a room.
Wait a minute. Give me that phone. Well, I thought it was the phone. Terribly sorry. I didn't make that mistake. It's natural. And besides, you're not supposed to have a telephone. We're doing a thing. It's 100 years before the phone was invented.
That's because we got riders who never went past the fourth grade.
Hello, this is Meriwether Clark, the intrepid explorer. I'd like 360 peanut butter sandwiches, 150 salami and cheese, and 40 gallons of coffee. 1 moment.
Do you want anything?
Yeah.
30 pounds of after-dinner mince. 30 pounds, you got it? Of after-dinner mince.
Oh, never.
What was that?
I think it was a girl. You wait here, I'll be back in a couple of weeks.
Just a minute. I'm working here too. You know something, you're always chasing girls.
That's not true, that's not true. Not since sweet Seattle Sue smiled at me.
All right, now wait a minute.
What?
Say that again, and say it slower, so I'll have time to go over to the piano and make things okay, so they come in with the introduction on time.
Gonna saddle up and settle in Seattle, 'cause that's the one and only thing I gotta do. I'm gonna saddle up and settle in Seattle with my sweet Seattle Sue.
Her cheeks are rosy, her complexion fair, and what she's missing here, she's bound to have there.
I'm gonna saddle up and settle in Seattle
with my sweet Seattle Sue.
Boy, what a gal.
Yeah.
She had beautiful eyes.
Beautiful eyes.
And a curly head.
A curly head?
Yeah. No hair, just a curly head. If you go strolling with Sue in the park, and if she kisses you, look out, Lewis.
Look out, huh? I'm gonna saddle up and settle in Seattle with my sweet Seattle Sue. With my sweet Seattle Sue. State I'm in. Where's the map?
Well, it's out in the covered wagon in the glove compartment.
I'm kidding. Wait a minute, wait a minute. I just remembered. We're in Washington, the state of Washington, where the apples come from.
Now we're getting to the core of it.
You didn't really say that.
Be with you in apple blossom time. I'll be with you in the shade of the old apple tree. Oh, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. Anyone else but me. Anyone else but me. Oh, no, no, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me.
Yes, we have no banana.
In the shade of the old apple tree.
Life is just a bowl of cherries, so live and laugh at it all.
An apple for the teacher.
If you want to be a top banana, you gotta start at the bottom of the
shade of the old apple tree.
Lemon tree, oh so pretty.
Oh, don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me.
Yes, we have no banana.
In the shade of the old apple tree.
When banana skins are falling, I'll be sliding home to you.
God did make little green apples, and it don't rain in Indian apples in the summertime. There's no such thing as Dr. Seuss, Disneyland and Mother Goose is no nursery rhyme. God did make
the apple tree with anyone else but me. Anyone else but me.
Now there's one place keeps calling me, just one place I've gotta be, sitting in the shade of the old apple tree. In Seattle.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's our show for tonight. We want to thank our guest, Jimmy Rogers, and our special guest star, Danny Thomas.
May we wish you well. May the good Lord bless you. And may He always send you a happy day.
Good night.